Hello, good day. Happy New Year's to all my friends. Hope you are well and strong. And in this new year, I'm going to bring you a new nations will be actually cover the next 6 episodes. This nations, I'm also very excited to share with you, is China. And of course, China is just a large country, and therefore I can be very specifically selecting a province, and this province that I'm going to introduce you today is Xinjiang. It's actually located as the northwestern part of China. You can look at the map in front of you. The area that covered in red is a Xinjiang province. Xinjiang province is the largest province in China and had taken up about 1/6 of the land area of China. And for us to understand better about Xinjiang, Xinjiang had been a controversial area in many years, but our visit to Xinjiang was taken place over the last 10 years. In fact, the most recent visit I have to Xinjiang is only about 2 years ago. There are a lot of much progress and improvement in Xinjiang province. And I want to share about some background. Before we go further, let's look at some of the geographical facts about Xinjiang. Xinjiang is happened to be due to its large land mass. And in order to travel to Xinjiang, you have to be very specific whether it's northern Xinjiang and southern Xinjiang. And interestingly, it's quite different. The northern portion and the southern portion, there's quite a distinct differences in terms of cultures, in terms of landscapes. And if you look at the maps, we have the northern Xinjiang are colored in reds, and the southern Xinjiang is colored in blues. And the demarcation of the northern and southern Xinjiang are by virtue of a geographical reason. And then look at the next maps. You look at this map itself showing 3 mountain ranges that actually cutting across the Xinjiang province. The southernmost, we have the Kunlun mountain range. The northern part, you have the mountain range. And right at the center is the Tian Shan mountain range. It's this Tian Shan mountain range that divides the Xinjiang into the northern and the southern portions. While looking at the southern portion in Xinjiang, you can realize actually is a basin. And this basin is housed one of the largest deserts in the world. I will share with you later on when I cover more of the southern part of Xinjiang in my subsequent travelogues. And therefore, the city that we are going to visit is called Kashgar. And it's regarded one of the westmost city in China. It's so close to the borders. And basically, Kashgar is an oasis city in Xinjiang, China. It's also known as a Kashis. Being the westmost city of China is a border to 4 nations, namely the Kazakhstan, Tajikistan, Afghanistan, and Pakistan, right? And let's move up the next. You can see that in this map, you see the red line. This red line are all the ancient silk routes, all the routes that taken during the ancient time. And happened to be Kashgar, this city, because located in the ancient silk routes, it have actually have more than 2,000 years of history. And is one of the oldest and continuously inhabited city in the world. And is a pivotal trading post as well as trading gateways to the west. To the west is actually to Middle East as well as to Europe, while to the south is actually towards Southern Asia, which cover India and Pakistan. So until today, that Kashgar still is one of the important trading city in these regions. And so we then move on to more about Kashgar. Kashgar, as I said earlier, is a 2,000-year ancient city and been an important meeting point, right, on the Silk Road, Kashgar becoming the melting point of several unique groups of culture. Kashgar were once ruled under four empires, that namely the Turkish, the Mongol, the Tibetan, and the Chinese. So Kashgar have a vigorous population of around 500,000 and own the largest mosque in the whole China. And the name of the mosque is the Kah Mosque, which I'm going to share with you in this episode. Now, most travelers will definitely agree with me. If you want to see true color of Xinjiang, you must visit Kashgar. And a point to note that Kashgar frequently face sandstorms, right, from the desert nearby, Taklamakan deserts, which make the atmosphere unbreathable. So therefore, you should take note and get yourself prepared, just in case. Now, Kashgar, this city, a 2,000-year city, the city center was once surrounded by perimeter wall. Right? It is quite normal to see that in an ancient city, that in order as a defense, they had built perimeter wall around the city. The only wall remaining to date is the Western Wall, but of course that it's been well preserved and have been stay until today. When night fall, that this external facade of this old city wall, and particularly the Eastern City Gates, which was built quite recently, will be lighted up, right? And with multicolor light performance, which you will see some of the images later on. Now, most of the building or dwelling in the old city area have been rebuilt, right? And still using mud bricks. Part of the old city have been rebuilt, but still retain its traditional architecture style, which again I'm going to share with you. Let's go on with some of the images as we go further. Now, this is exactly the close view of this Eastern Gate, City Gates, and you can see that when we are there in the morning, we are able in time to catch the cultural performance. They have two cultural performances daily, and one of them is in the morning, and the one quite close to the noon time. And as the crowd start to gather, right, because you had to go early, then you get the best spot. But you go later, you found that you had to stand behind the crowd. And we were there not considered early, so that we had to find our way to stand as close as to open area, so that I can able to capture some nice images of the cultural performance. And for the start, you found that some vigorous people will then start to do some dancing with the music that been turned on. And of course, later you found that some lady dancers join in. And the interesting part is that they do invite and welcome visitors to join in. Therefore, you can see some of the tourists are also in the dancing floor. And then when finally the actual cultural performance began, and you find that there's a pretty ladies do an intro, the MC of the day. And then you have some parade, and we found that all the people who are in the parade are dressed up in the traditional Uyghur costume. And this is basically a far view, and right below the Eastern Gate, you find that the dancer is doing their dance performance. And then there are further parade where you have a musician performing the local numbers using the traditional instrument, musical instruments. And of course, they also have some fairy tales of the locals, and they also dress and perform part of the parade. So when night fall, of course, we did not tour the old city center for the whole days. We adjourned our travel to some other part and we came back in the night just to make sure we don't miss the night performance. You can see the light, the laser light show have started as shown in this image. And in order to attract and enhance the beauty of this part of our old city, most of the city external wall or the facades were lighted up. And this, when you look at this scene, actually is right opposite the eastern gates, and it's also is the night never fall, and as far concerned, there house a night market. But first, we do not visit a night market on the first day; we visit on the second night. And as far concerned, I will share with you of this night market in the next episode. That is the next weekend. And of course, it's very interesting place to visit Kashgar. And this is one of the tallest telecommunication towers. And equally, like most other city, they are also well decorated with colorful lights and will light up, and the light change colors every 5 or 10 seconds, and I managed to capture where the light color been changed. Actually, it's only single telecommunication tower, but then I have actually taken 3 images of 3 different colors. I put them together in this same slides. It's not 3 tower, but actually it's only 1 tower in 3 different colors. And then the nearby have a food court or food plaza, but however, we haven't taken our dinner, so therefore we just pass by. In fact, that if you were to be on a free and easy, it's worthwhile to try it. But of course, I will recommend you try to visit the night market. You can find more traditional Uyghur foods or cuisine there, right? Now, see, the important thing that we need to note that the Kashgar city, old city, as I mentioned earlier, it's undergo rebuilt by the China government, and as a result of these reconstructions, that they have widened the roads and the building, of course, all those recent completed buildings are in good condition and good shape, and at the same time, they still maintain the original architecture style. And you can see from this image that the street is very, very wide. This is one of the main streets in the old city district, right immediately after the eastern gate. Let's look at the images, and you can see both sides there have a lot of shops, and all these shops are mainly selling souvenirs, handicraft, painting of that, like, you know, the local product. So these are some of the architecture's style that still retain on the buildings, wall, or even on the facade of the building. Most of the buildings are of 3-story, 2 to 3-story, and rarely we found any of the building that higher than the 3-story height. The windows are very impressive. So we spent quite a mourning, quite a full mourning in these districts. But it's not enough time. Frankly speaking, if you really want to explore this old district of Kashgar, you have to allocate yourself to one full day. And of course, it's my usual practice. I like to take doll. Doll actually tells story, and most people are willing to invest money on their front door, the main door. And as far as concerned, that is door, the way the door is constructed and decorated, in one way or another, reflects the status of the owner of the house, and also the history of the building. Some of decoration they have done on the wall. And this is some of the street nearby. It's not the main street, but a side or alley, or lanes. You find that there's less crowd, less people, and more simple and plain. And interestingly, it's very, very clean. The street is very, very clean. And this is one of the images I like, that you can see the aging door and windows, the wooden parts. And then we also come across some of the food vendors. And happened this lady is selling what is so-called yao cha kuai into to the Cantonese or to Malaysian, you will know what I mean. But they're using a different type of flour. They're using a wheat flour that's been used to create the local bread, the naan, or naan, we call naan. And they're using the same material, ingredients, and do this yao cha kuai. And my wife says it's very, very nice to eat. And they did try. Yes, in fact, it's very, very different from the yao cha kuai we have in Malaysia. And some of the local snacks. And they also sell some form of local product, like a specialty, like using the milk, the cow milk or the goat milk products. Nuts, dry nuts, right? And also the seed. And also the dry fruits are abundantly there. You know. Our visit was actually during the autumn months. And a lot of souvenir store. In fact, you can buy one or two very attractive, very skillful, done the handicraft by the local treatments. Some musical instruments, local artist painting, very, very impressive. Sorry for the, this is actually the precious stones. The lady made like this. And they even sell raw stone. Of course, the price are much cheaper, but I'm not sure if you are not an expert in this field. You may think that it's precious, but by bought back, it's actually a normal stone. So try your luck. And a lot of wooden handicraft. It's a lot of store, and all short of the all type of souvenir you wish you found in Xinjiang or in Kashgar, you could literally find here. But about the pricing there, I'm not sure, because this considered one of a tourist spot, and probably it could be slightly expensive, but maybe not necessarily. Sometimes because of competition, the price can be very reasonable. One thing you have to take note that the the measurement weight measurement unit in this part of the China. In China, when they call Yijing, or we call them one kati, you know, in Malay, they have one called one kati. One kati equivalent to 600 grams. But in China, their Yijing is mean actually is only half a kilo. But in this part of the world, they don't practice the Yijing, the half kilo measurement weight unit. They use Yijing in mean 1 kilogram. So remember, when you buy here, you say you want Yijing, it give you 1 kilogram, right? So the take note of that. And the paperless money is still not very popular over here. So if you come here, please make sure you have enough change, enough Chinese currency, renminbi, because more often than not, that all the purchase are done using actual notes or currency notes, not the so-called paperless as what you see in the more developed coastal town like Shanghai, like Guangzhou. And I like these miniatures on the right, you know, where they're handicraft, right below there's a nice picture of the tigers. And right on the left is a the copperware, you know. In fact, the picture on the right is actually is for tourists to go and take picture with the birds, but you have to pay for a nominal fees. And these are some alley, and also on the right, there's one smith shop, you know, producing local traditional tools. Musician who had did the performance this morning, and then they're taking a rest and take a stroll on their own street, and at the same time, or sit right in front of the shop, playing the local music numbers, and the performer also found around the street to do some street performing. Here we come to, just now I mentioned this ID Kah Mosque. The ID Kah Mosque is also known as Ida Mosque, right? It is the largest mosque by land area in Xinjiang and also in China. It was then it was built in the year 1442 and was by the rulers of Kashgar and as a prayer hall initially. And then it was then rebuilt in 1798, quite near to the end of 18th centuries, and further expansion to current size, which actually in 1832, right? It have a history of near to 560 years. And it was believed to be the mosque site was one a cemetery. And it believed also that the words they given to this Ika Mosque are actually the Uyghur's language, mean, what should I say, is a place of praying and festival celebration. Because of that, this place, any major festival function, grand festival function, they were held here. And for that reason, that is actually located right at the old city district of Kashgar. And this ID Kah Mosque was just next to a square bearing the same name, ID Kah Square, right? And the mosque cover and floor area of 16,800 square meters, which comprised of a gate tower we can see from this image, a large prayer hall, two rows of doctrines teaching rooms with night room on each side, and a large courtyard with poplar trees, right? A local species of tree, which I'm going to share with you subsequently in the later part of the subsequent few episodes. Now, during the major religious festival, as I mentioned earlier, by the name itself, they already recognized this as a spot for holding all this festival. The mosque can accommodate up to 10,000 worshiper inside the mosque compound. But if it were to be expanded, including the ID card square would be used for the purpose, then you can find that it can accommodate up to 20,000, double the capacity. So the most impressive part of this mosque is not the interior, but rather just the gate towers, which will elaborately decorated, carved and tiled with flower and Islamic patterns. But of course, in China, it considered one of the best decorated. But if you want to see a true Islamic architectures, you should not miss my subsequent travelogues to a nation called Iran, which I've just showcased 60 awesome images recently, yesterday. Right? So please, if you have not seen these 60 images of the Iran or called Persian architectures of arts, then please do so after these episodes. When you travel to southern Xinjiang, particularly southern Xinjiang, you bear in mind that there's a lot of security check. Almost all major shopping malls, airports, the train stations, they have this scanner to scan your personal belongings, your luggage, as well as any person who are going inside this complex or this area, tourist spot, they have a scanner. So please get yourself prepared. It may take up some time of your traveling because of this security check. So let's look at some of these images of this ID card mosque. Personally, we did not enter this mosque because we have actually earlier visited some other mosques nearby, and I was told the interior decoration is certainly much better than this. So we don't spend our time visiting the interior part of this ID Kah Mosque, but rather we prefer to spend our time on the street nearby, because B is right at the old city center, and next, just beside the whole mosque area, is actually a shopping district and lady like best. So this is some of the close view of these towers. And this is actually the ceiling work, the integrated timber works at the entrance porch of this grand mosque. And this is a straight dimension run parallel to the mosque, because the mosque is an elongated building compound, so actually this street is run parallelly, and it's quite a long street for us to shop and to look around. So this is just the initial views from one end of the street. You can look at this. This street itself is comparatively to just now the Eastern Gate itself. This look like it's more traditional, undisturbed street scene, as compared with the old DC street, which was under rebuild and reconstructions. So the color scheme, the architecture style are vary from building to building. And this is exactly the tea house where we recommended to give ourselves a try of the local tea, Uyghur tea. Most of it are called milk tea. You can see this in the residential section of the street, and we are the only travelers there, and you find that they have actually spent a lot of time in decorating the building facade. These are all street alley or lanes, side lanes or inner lanes, at the resident area, residential. And you can see that during these few images, you find out a lot of China national flags were hung up. Happened to be our visit was right after the Chinese National Days. So you can find a lot of Chinese national flags everywhere in this old town district. And not to surprise, actually, the streets are well kept, very, very clean. You hardly can find any debris or rubbish they've been thrown around. Well kept, very, very clean. And some of the decorations, items that displays on the street. Door. You can see the two different doors. Totally show a different aspect of it. Some of the ironmongers that mounted on the doors. And this further street scene, some street photography. The painting is very impressive here. All these are quite highly crafted handicraft. Very skillfully done. And this also we found some store selling leatherware and also a huge copper teacup, tea bowl. And some children are playing on the street. This is actually the side alley. They place a carpet on it and they play their cards and the game, the card game. And on the right is a smith working on the metal products. And that's the end of today. I promise you all the subsequent 5 episodes will be very, very much interesting. And if you like my travel channels, these travelogues, and all the subsequent travelogues to come, please do subscribe, like, and share, so that you will notify whenever there's new uploads. I thank you very much for staying with me until at the end of these travelogues. And as usual, I wish everybody good health. And please stay strong, and hopefully the world will reopen again and we can travel again. But don't worry, my travel will still continue. I believe can last for at least a year of my images that I've actually compiled over the last 20 years. Right? So see you in the next episode, Kashgar, Xinjiang, China, part 2 of 2. More interesting of the local cuisine will be showcased in the part 2. See you again and bye. Thank you very much.